And in the Cy Young race for the National League, updating here, Scherzer, Noah, DeGrom, none of those will get a decision tonight, even though for the most part, they all pitched rather well. Scherzer not typical, but let's update the Cy Young vote. And JP, I'll start with you. If you're voting based on what you've seen so far, who would you vote?
Jacob DeGrom. Now, the key thing about the Cy Young...
He's very firm.
Well, he didn't hesitate.
He is the choice. Now, listen, there's a difference, in my opinion, between the MVP, which I do consider team success,
of course,
and the Cy Young, which goes to the best pitcher, period, full stop. And the best pitcher in the National League this year has been Jacob DeGrom. He leads in wins above replacement. He also leads in fielding independent pitching, which I look at it and say the Mets, maybe not the best defensive team in baseball, Nick. I think that maybe that has hurt him at times, as has, of course, the run support and lack thereof. The totality of what DeGrom has done consistently, and yes, he has not been pitching for teammates in it, but the excellent way that he's pitched all season long, all the metrics, ERA leads the National League, leads the majors, leads in wins above replacement, best fielding independent pitching, better than Scherzer by about half a run. DeGrom is the choice for me.
I mean, he gives a lot of good examples on why. Let me tell you my guy. And he lost tonight, but I'm telling you, I think Max Scherzer is going to win the Cy Young. He's already got 3 days named. If he wins his fourth one, that puts him in elite company for sure.
He may already be a Hall of Famer.
Yeah, automatically Hall of Famer. So here's the thing, man. He leads in pretty much every other category other than ERA. He's one of those guys. Now, what you were talking about earlier is you want the best pitcher in Jacob DeGrom. This kind of reminds me of Felix Hernandez back when he won the Cy Young, when he was 13-12. But that year, he was so much better than everybody else in the league. This year, we've got Aaron Nola. We've got Max Scherzer.
Right.
You know, there's so many other guys that you can pick from. So this is kind of one of those years, in my opinion, where I feel like those wins might hurt him a little bit.
Yeah, and he didn't lose. The Nationals came back. He gave up 3 earned runs, whereas only one.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
One earned run for Nola and one earned run for DeGrom. But again, not the typical Scherzer performance. But across the board, his numbers have been outstanding.
Absolutely.
He's really been the one piece of glue that has held that Nationals team together. Now they got a little bit of a winning streak. And the Diamondbacks Giants are underway as well. We'll check on the leaders of the National League West. In fact, Arizona quietly, I say, because Goldschmidt had the rough start.
Yep.
They had their dip, but they've spent more time in first place than any other team that's been in first place this year in the division. How have they been able to maintain that lead?
Chris, to me, it's been Paul Goldschmidt. And we think about the way his season began, middle of May. He was batting under 200.
That's crazy, right?
Just like Matt Carpenter was in St. Louis. And he has been playing now like an MVP once again. And maybe this is his year to win the MVP. We know, Nick, what a great fundamental player he is. He runs the bases so well. He plays first base defensively so well. He is still at this point in time, I believe, something of an underrated star in this game. You look at his resume, the one he's compiling, eventually by the end of his career, you may think of him as a Hall of Famer. But the big moments, he hasn't quite had them yet. Maybe this is the year when, if he pushes them into the playoffs, he gets those moments.
Well, yeah, also, too, man, it's also his personality.
Yes.
He's not a big, boisterous guy. He's a real quiet dude, just loves to come to the ballpark and do his job each and every day. As good as I feel that Paul Goldschmidt has been, I don't think the Arizona Diamondbacks are where they are if it's not for David Peralta. Listen, man, this guy already has career highs in home runs and wins above replacement. And he's only one of 4 players in the National League that's hitting over 300 with 20 bombs and 20 doubles. This guy is absolutely having a tremendous year. I love him. In my opinion, this guy's the MVP for the Arizona Diamondbacks.
I love the story of Peralta because you think about his career, Nick. He began as a pitcher in the Cardinals system. Then he was released when he got hurt. He went to play independent ball. The Diamondbacks have a great scout by the name of Chris Carminucci, who scouts independent leagues very, very well. He finds him playing independent ball and signs him, makes this great journey through his career. It's an amazing story.
He has been
extraordinary, and I agree. He somewhere is in the MVP conversation.
Yeah,
as well.
And the Clay Buchholz story is a good one. Great find. He's pitching well tonight, scoreless in the fourth for the Diamondbacks.